Hey guys, Jeffrey from Headstrong Training Systems here. So today we're going to be looking at the deadlift, and in particular, we're going to be talking about the slack pull and the wedge, or the wedge in particular. And I want to talk about the concept of treating your torso as one system when you're wedging. And I know that sounds a bit confusing, but basically what I mean by that is whenever we wedge, we want to treat our torso as having packed down our ribcage, having packed a flat torso, and we don't want any deviation of either the chest or the hips during that wedge, because that's going to throw off our movement pattern. Now let me just show you guys a demonstration so you guys can get a better understanding of what I'm talking about. So say for example, I perform my hinge, I get down into a great bottom position. This is my starting position. When I see a lot of people, they take their slack pull, and then when they wedge through, they either flex at their hips, so they do hip flexion, see a rounding on my back at first, or they might do something with their chest, they might do too much extension at the chest. So you see that they're deviating from maintaining, treating the torso as one unit, because essentially if this is my torso angle, when I wedge through or when I do my slack pull, we want to maintain the integrity of this torso angle. And so when I perform movements of it and I manipulate it, I'm treating this torso as one unit, so everything's being maintained regardless of the movement I perform. But when we let our hips either flex or our chest extend during the movement, we're essentially letting other areas of the body, of that torso, do what it wants. So I'm taking it out of alignment. I'm suddenly letting my hips flex through rather than bringing my torso through. And you can see in the video, what happened before was that my spine rounded straight away, or vice versa. When I let my chest rise during that wedge through, you see what happens? Extension occurs in that back. So basically what I'm trying to say is when we wedge through in the deadlift after you take stack out, treat the torso as one unit. When you're wedging through, maintain that angle instead of letting the hips flex or letting the chest extend. So that's all from me today, guys. Hopefully that was helpful for you, and I'll catch you guys next time. Take care.